Good morning, Place Church, and happy Sunday.
Buenos días, Iglesia, y feliz domingo. Un buen día.
Are there any veterans in the church this morning?
Hay algunos veteranos en la iglesia hoy.
Will you please stand?
Por favor, apárate.
Can we all give our veterans a hand?
Por favor, un aplauso para ellos.
Thank you, veterans, for doing what you do.
Feliz día de veteranos.
Could I have everybody else please stand as well?
Y para toda iglesia, apárate, por favor.
We are going to learn a new song together.
Aprendemos una nueva canción hoy.
This song is called Goodbye Yesterday.
La canción se llama Goodbye Yesterday.
And we are going to learn the chorus before we actually sing the song.
Y vamos a aprender el estribillo antes la resta.
And give it up for Señor Davies.
Yeah.
Sing with me, please.
Por favor, todos juntos.
Adiós al ayer, hoy vivo el nuevo amanecer. No hay razón para quedarme en el pasado. Gloria a Dios, he nacido otra vez. Adiós al ayer, hoy vivo el nuevo amanecer. No hay razón para quedarme en el pasado. Gloria a Dios, he nacido otra vez.
And one time in English.
Goodbye yesterday, I'm living in the light of a new day. I won't waste another minute in my old ways. Praise the Lord, I've been born again.
Muy, muy bien. Woo. I don't want to say it, but here we go.
Amen. You can be seated.
Amen. Pueden ser sentados.
We'd like to welcome you here today.
Queremos darles la bienvenida hoy.
Thank you so much for being here.
Gracias por estar aquí esta mañana.
Today is the day to rejoice in the Lord.
Hoy vamos a festejar en el Señor.
Jesus is good.
Jesús es bueno.
You know, the Bible says where two or more gathered, there he is.
La Biblia dice donde dos o más están juntos, ahí está él.
God is in this place, amen?
Dios está aquí, amen.
And we're going to celebrate that today.
Vamos a celebrar eso hoy.
In just a minute, we're going to have some announcements for you.
En un minuto vamos a tener unos anuncios para ustedes.
But before I do that, I want to let you know that we have some sign-ups in the back.
Pero antes de decir eso, atrás tenemos unos folletos para que usted pueda inscribirse.
We're doing a great outreach on Thanksgiving, or Thanksgiving meal.
El Día de Acción de Gracias vamos a tener una celebración con comida aquí.
And there's sign-ups in the back where if you want to help in any area, you can sign up there.
Y usted puede inscribirse si puede ayudar ese día.
But right now what we're going to do is we're going to see Pastor Gilly talk about the announcements for the church.
Pero ahorita vamos a ver el Pastor Gilly hacer unos anuncios.
Check this out.
Miren esto.
Good morning, you beautiful people. Welcome home. Get ready for Sunday morning announcements. I want to let you know that we are doing a Thanksgiving offering today. This is going to be our third annual community Thanksgiving dinner. And if you want to help support that, then there's going to be special envelopes that you can go ahead and put your offering into that. That'll help us put on this awesome event. Last year, over 150 people came. This year, probably even more. So thank you so much for your support. I want to let you know that Timothy's House is having their high stakes benefit dinner supporting Timothy's House Orphanage. So it's going to be a great time. You're going to be able to get a filet mignon. It's going to be a lot of fun. There's going to be a live band there. They also, for my 2A fans that shoot Freedom Seeds, they are going to be having some awesome raffles. They're going to be selling tickets today. If you need them, go ahead and see Karen Dawson. The Red Letter Challenge is still going on every weekday at 5 p.m. You guys can come here to The Place Church and dive deeper into your Red Letter Challenge book with a community of believers. Women's event, you guys got some fun things going on. Take a listen to this.
Good morning. Women's Ministry has their fall gathering coming up, Attitude of Gratitude. We'll have a catered lunch, a special message, and we'll be having a book exchange. So collect any Bible study books, inspirational books, or Christian fiction that you'd like to share with someone else. And feel free to take home a few as well. Please sign up at the Welcome Center or online. We need an accurate count to provide to our caterer. Next, we are holding a women's retreat on Saturday, January 18th at Standing Stones Conference Center. The retreat theme is Refresh, Renew, Restore, and will include biblical learning and discussion, worship, time for personal reflection, and an opportunity for spiritual growth with other women. Registration is limited to the first 32 ladies, and payment is $50, is due at the time of registration. Cost of the retreat includes breakfast, lunch, and all materials. Sign up at the Welcome Center or online. We look forward to having you.
That's all I have for announcements today. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your Sunday. I hope you have a great next week. Remember, I love you, and be the reason someone smiles. Peace.
What great advice. Be the reason someone smiles.
Sé la razón que alguien sonríe hoy.
Yeah, it's important, isn't it?
Es importante, ¿no?
Thank you. Thank you.
Gracias.
Today is a very special day at our church.
Hoy es un día especial hoy en la iglesia.
Once a month, we celebrate the gift of communion with each other.
Una vez al mes, hacemos la comunión.
Today is that day.
Hoy es ese día.
As I was studying, it was really interesting to learn about the early church.
Yo estaba estudiando, era muy interesante lo que hacían al principio.
At the center of every ancient church gathering was something.
En el centro de las iglesias antiguas.
It was the Lord's Supper.
Era la comunión de Jesús.
That was the center of the church.
Era el centro de la iglesia.
It was the main focus.
Era la parte importante.
Everyone that came there was there to celebrate Jesus.
Todos los que iban allí, en eso se enfocaban.
Over time, that has changed.
Durante el tiempo, eso iba cambiando.
Churches now have stages and podiums.
Las iglesias ahora tienen altares.
And that becomes the center of your Sunday.
Y eso es el centro del domingo.
But we're here to tell you no.
Pero aquí estoy para decirte que no es.
This is why we're here.
Esto es por lo que estamos aquí.
Jesus is the reason.
Jesús es la razón.
He has been good to us.
Él ha sido bueno con nosotros.
And in communion we celebrate that.
Y en comunión celebramos eso.
So we're going to come together in a minute and celebrate the gift of communion together.
Ahora todos nos vamos a juntar en un minuto para tomar la comunión juntos.
Now when you come to the front, everyone can come and then you can come back around to your area.
Cuando ustedes vengan, van a salir por aquí, pueden dar la vuelta y regresar a sus asientos.
But this may be your first communion, and so I want to just tell you a little bit.
Pero tal vez esta sea la primera vez que usted lo vaya a tomar.
When you come up to get your communion,
cuando usted venga a agarrarlo,
we actually in this bowl here have gluten-free.
Es son gluten-free.
And that's for you.
Y es para usted.
To serve you.
Para servirle a usted.
And then here at the church, we don't use wine.
Y aquí no servimos vino.
We use juice.
Usamos jugo.
To remember that moment at the Last Supper.
Para recordar ese momento en la última cena de Jesús.
And in just a minute, we're going to invite you to the front.
Y en un minuto los vamos a invitar hacia arriba.
We want you to get representing the bread and the wine.
Vamos a agarrar el pan representando y el vino.
And bring it back to your seat with you.
Y luego va a regresar a su asiento.
And then we're going to take it together.
Y todos lo vamos a tomar juntos.
And we're going to complete this moment by praying the Lord's Prayer.
Y vamos a cerrar orando.
So in just a moment, I'm going to invite Tyler up here to the front, and then he's going to help us come up.
En un momento vamos a invitar al Tyler para que venga y vamos a orar.
And then he's going to dismiss you to come up to the front to Gilly and I.
Y luego cuando él termine ya pueden venir hacia enfrente para agarrar.
You can come get, receive, and then come back to your seat.
Agarrar, recibir y sentarse.
Come forward. Body of Christ broken for you. So now as we are here,
ahora estamos aquí,
we remember Jesus' Last Supper.
Estamos recordando la última cena de Jesús.
He came with his disciples and broke bread.
Él vino con sus discípulos y quebró el pan.
He talked about the bread being his body.
Él habló y dijo que el pan era su cuerpo.
And how his body would be broken for us.
Y como su cuerpo sería quebrantado por nosotros.
Take and eat.
Toma y come.
And we remember the precious words that Jesus said.
Y nosotros recordamos las palabras hermosas que Jesús dijo.
The blood of the new covenant.
La sangre nueva.
Today we remember with grateful hearts.
Ahora recordamos con los corazones llenos de felicidad.
And we thank him.
Y le damos agradecimiento.
Take and drink. Something very important for us is sealing our communion time by saying a simple prayer.
Algo importante para nosotros es cerrar esto con una oración.
The prayer is known as the Lord's Prayer.
La oración es conocido como el Padre Nuestro.
And the Our Father is a very important prayer to us.
Y el Padre Nuestro es una oración muy importante para nosotros.
Now we've done something different today for our service.
Hemos hecho algo diferente hoy para nuestro servicio.
Can you put the prayer up for me, please?
¿Puedes poner la oración, por favor?
Ambos lenguas. Did I say it right? Lenguas? Lenguas.
Lenguajes.
Lenguajes.
Sí.
I'm working on it. Ambos lenguajes.
Both languages.
Sí, for us.
Yes, para nosotros.
Okay. So we're going to say the Our Father, Padre Nuestro, together. Okay. ¿Listo?
Lo vamos a decir juntos, el Padre Nuestro. ¿Listos?
Okay, I'll say in English, you can say in Spanish, we'll all meet at the end. Ready? Our Father.
Venganos nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en la tentación y líbranos del mal. Amén. Pueden ser parados, por favor. Vamos a continuar alabando a Dios con las canciones. Amén.
nunca fallará.
Sing with me, I sought the Lord. Give you praise.
Al Señor, agradecemos.
Fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Toma juntos con su espíritu.
And let us be ready to hear your word.
Y seguramos que estamos aprender su.
In Jesus' name.
En Jesús nombre.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You can be seated. Siéntate.
You may be seated.
Good morning again.
Buenos días de nuevo.
We're so honored to have you here.
Estamos honrados por tenerlos aquí.
And we're smack dab right in the middle of a series.
Y ahorita estamos en medio de una serie.
A series simply entitled Red Letter Living.
Esta serie se llama Las Letras Rojas.
And we talked about how the red letters were the words of Jesus.
Y hablamos cómo las letras rojas son las palabras de Dios en la Biblia.
And so for 40 days we've been looking at the words of Jesus.
Entonces estos 40 días hemos estado viendo las palabras de Dios.
Every day.
Todos los días.
We meet here.
Aquí nos juntamos.
Every day at 5 o'clock.
Todos los días a las 5 de la tarde.
But people are doing the devotional all over.
Pero la gente lo está haciendo en todos los lugares.
And they're growing closer to God.
Y están creciendo más junto con Dios.
And then we've made a commitment on Sundays to talk about the important things.
Y entonces en los domingos estamos hablando de las cosas importantes.
They call them keystones.
Ellos les hablan las cosas que llaman la atención.
The important thing we're trying to grab a hold of.
La cosa importante que queremos agarrar.
And today's important thing is this.
Y ahora la cosa importante de hoy es esto.
Prioritizing prayer is important.
La oración, ponerlo que sea nuestra prioridad.
Amen.
Amen.
Most of us would agree with that.
Muchos de nosotros diríamos que estamos de acuerdo.
The thing that really opened my eyes, though, was the meaning of this word.
Lo que realmente abrió mis ojos es esta palabra.
This word, priority.
La palabra prioridad.
Now, when it first entered into English,
cuando esta palabra recién entró en inglés,
it had a very specific definition.
Significaba algo muy específica.
The definition was this.
La definición era esto.
The state of being first.
Cuando la palabra entró por primera vez en inglés significa es el estado de ser el primero.
First.
Primero.
One.
Uno.
Primary.
Prioridad.
So when you look at this priority that we're called to have.
Entonces cuando tú ves esta prioridad que él nos ha llamado a tener.
It's kind of interesting to me what has happened over time.
Es interesante para mí al ver lo que ha pasado durante el tiempo.
And we can look back at history of discovering the problem.
Podemos ver hacia atrás en la historia para ver cuál fue el problema.
As society and its demands became more complex, especially in the industrial and post-industrial eras, the idea of multiple priorities emerged.
A medio que la sociedad y sus demandas se volvieron más complejas, especialmente en las eras industrial y posindustrial, surgió la idea de prioridades múltiples.
This was a new idea.
Esto es una idea nueva.
Bosses began to talk about priorities.
Los jefes empezaron a hablar de la prioridad.
In fact, most people here, when you hear priority, it's plural.
Muchas personas aquí cuando hablan de la prioridad, ¿qué es lo que piensan?
That's how we use it now.
Así es como lo usamos ahora.
First priority, second priority, third priority.
Primera prioridad, segunda prioridad, tercera prioridad.
And if you think about your relationship with God, it's the same way.
Y si tú piensas en tu relación con Dios, es lo mismo.
What is a priority of a Christian?
¿Qué es la prioridad de un cristiano?
What is an important thing to make part of your life?
¿Qué es lo importante de tu vida?
Love, by
amor.
Living love. Great example. What else? Worship. Have been worshiping there. Great. What else?
Alabar.
Singing.
Cantando.
Exactly. Singing. What else?
Exactamente.
Serving. Making
Sirviendo.
That a priority. Good. What else? Prayer.
Oración.
Good. What else? Say it again. Familia, familia.
Family.
Exactly. What about la Biblia?
¿Qué tal la Biblia? The Bible.
La Biblia es muy importante.
She said, read the Bible.
Read the Bible. Sí, sí. That helps. So we have all of these things. And depending on who you ask,
tenemos todas esas cosas. Y dependiendo a quien le preguntes,
they'll tell you which one is the most important.
Ellos te van a decir cuál es la prioridad de ellos.
It's kind of what we're looking at today.
Eso es lo que estamos viendo hoy.
Everything we said is important.
Todo lo que dijeron es muy importante.
It all helps to make us a stronger Christian.
Todo ayuda para ser un cristiano más fuerte.
But which one is most important?
Pero ¿a cuál es más importante?
It wasn't until I saw this video from Billy Graham.
No fue hasta que yo vi este video de este hermano llamado Billy Graham.
That I began to think about prayer and priority.
Que yo empecé a ver la prioridad y la oración.
Now Billy Graham was a great Christian and speaker.
Este hermano Billy Graham era un pastor.
And he spoke often about many things.
Y él muchas veces habló sobre muchos temas.
But I want us to hear his words on prayer.
Pero ahora quiero que ustedes escuchen sus palabras en la oración.
It's only about 2 minutes long.
Solamente dura 2 minutos.
And then we'll talk about it when it's done.
Y luego vamos a hablar cuando se termine.
Check it out.
All right, you have to learn to pray. You learn to pray in the same way. Lord, teach us to pray. Now remember, in living this Christian life, you don't have to live it alone. The Holy Spirit lives in you. The moment you receive Christ as your Savior, the Holy Spirit comes to live in you to give you the power, the strength, the wisdom, the courage to live the Christian life. Now the Holy Spirit also helps in your prayer life. The scripture says, likewise the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings that cannot be uttered. The Holy Spirit helps you to pray. Now may I make a suggestion? There are so many people that say, well, I don't feel like praying. I only pray when I feel like it. Then you're wrong. You should have a definite time and place every day to pray. You have an appointment. You have an interview with Almighty God. Suppose you had an interview with President Eisenhower tomorrow morning. You'd get up and say, well, I don't feel like seeing the president this morning. Or suppose you were going to be presented to the Queen. Well, I don't feel like it this morning. No, you'd be there. You'd be dressed in your best. You'd go and present yourself to the Queen. Well, every day, God, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, is waiting. He has given you an audience at any time of the day, and you fail to keep your appointment.
Ooh, ouch. Oi.
Oi.
Tough words.
Palabras muy difíciles, ¿no?
But true.
Pero verdades.
And I love the perspective shift.
Y oigo como, me gusta como él cambia la perspectiva.
That God has made an appointment for each of us every day.
Que Dios ha puesto una cita para todos nosotros todos los días.
I believe that with my whole heart.
Yo creo eso con todo mi corazón.
I believe God loves you that much.
Yo creo que Dios te ama.
He wants to spend time with you.
Él quiere pasar tiempo contigo.
But that's hard sometimes.
Pero es muy difícil a veces.
Because life is busy.
Porque la vida es ocupada.
And we have so much going on.
Tenemos muchas cosas que hacer.
But I think what we can take from Billy Graham was this idea of an appointment with God.
Pero creo que lo que podemos recibir de este pastor Billy Graham es que tenemos una cita con Dios.
What if we took that advice serious?
¿Qué tal si lo escucháramos y tomáramos eso?
What if we found a time and a place to spend with God daily?
¿Qué tal si nosotros nos tomáramos el tiempo en el día y pasáramos con Dios?
How would that affect our life?
¿Cómo eso afectaría tu vida?
You know, this idea of a daily meeting with God is important.
Esto de juntarte con Dios todos los días es muy importante.
Because it causes us to look at ourselves.
Porque luego nosotros estamos viendo cómo está, es nuestra vida.
You are the only one who can make this decision.
Tú eres la única persona que puede tomar esa decisión.
No one else can do it for
Nadie
you.
Nadie más lo puede hacer por ti.
You can make the decision.
Pero tú puedes tomar la decisión.
It's your life.
Es tu vida.
So what does this appointment look like?
Entonces, ¿qué es lo que estamos haciendo con esta cita?
It doesn't need to be an hour.
No tiene que ser una hora.
I wouldn't even say half hour.
Tampoco media hora.
It doesn't even need to be 15 minutes.
Ni 15 minutos.
What about five?
¿Qué tal si cinco?
Three?
Tres?
One?
Uno?
1 minute with God.
Un minuto con Dios.
Now here's the difference.
Esto es la diferencia.
I'm talking about an appointment.
Yo estoy hablando de una cita.
I'm talking about you setting up a time for you.
Yo estoy hablando que tú hagas esa cita.
I'm talking about you taking 1 minute out of your 24-hour day.
Que tú solamente saques un minuto de tus 24 horas en el día.
And focusing all of your heart and your attention on God.
Y te enfoques con toda tu mente y toda tu atención a Dios.
Imagine what that could look like.
Imagínate lo que eso podría ser.
Just 1 minute.
Solamente un minuto.
I often say 1 minute and people are like, ah, that's nothing.
He dicho un minuto y la gente dice, eso no es nada.
Until they grab a stopwatch.
Hasta que ellos empiezan a agarrar un reloj.
They set it down in front of them and hit start.
Lo ponen enfrente de ellos y le apachurran empezar.
A minute is a long time.
Un minuto es mucho tiempo.
The first time I did it, I was sure I was over a minute.
La primera vez que lo hice, yo dije, ay, me pasé del minuto.
42 seconds in.
42 segundos eran.
Have some grace on yourself.
Por favor, tengan gracia con ustedes mismos.
If you start with 1 minute, that's a minute more than you had yesterday.
Si empezaste con un minuto, era un minuto más que tuviste que ayer.
And if you added that up over the week, you're spending 7 minutes in prayer.
Y si dices, si lo hago todos los días, un minuto, entre semana, todos los días son 7 minutos.
I'm about to blow your mind.
Tu mente se va a explotar.
You do this for a month, it's like you spend a half hour praying.
Si lo haces por un mes, duraste media hora orando.
You never knew you were so spiritual.
Tal vez no, tú no sabes qué tan espiritual tú fuiste.
1 minute.
Un minuto.
What happens in this minute?
Lo que pasa en este minuto
is that you begin to discipline you.
Es lo que pasa es que empiezas a disciplinarte.
It's hard to make ourselves do something.
Muchas veces es difícil hacer que nosotros mismos hagamos algo.
In our mind, it's a great idea.
En nuestra mente es una idea fenomenal.
But when we start to do it, it isn't.
Pero cuando lo empezamos a hacer, ya no lo es.
We stop ourselves.
Nos paramos, nos detenemos.
But when I look at Scripture, I see a principle of prayer being the first thing.
Pero bíblicamente veo que la oración es lo principal.
And when I think about that, I look at Scripture.
Y cuando empiezo a pensar de eso, voy al versículo.
And if we went to the book of Luke, chapter 5, and looked at verses 15 and 16.
Y si vamos hacia la Biblia y abrimos en Lucas 5, 15, 16.
We would read these words.
Esto leyéramos.
Yet the news about him, Jesus, spread all the more, so the crowds of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sicknesses. But Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed.
Su fama se difundía cada vez más, y grandes multitudes se congregaban para oír a Jesús y ser sanadas en sus enfermedades.
Now, Jesus has a lot of people around him.
Ahora Jesús tiene mucha gente a su alrededor.
He's really, really busy.
Él está muy ocupado.
He's doing lots of stuff.
Él está haciendo muchas cosas.
He's busier than I am.
Él es más ocupado que yo.
And I can guarantee he's busier than you are.
Y te puedo garantizar que es más ocupado que tú.
But yet we can see how he lived.
Pero podemos ver cómo él vivió.
What he did.
Lo que él hizo.
And the other thing I want you to know is that Jesus was God.
Y otra cosa es que quiero que sepas que él es Dios.
Much of his actions were an example to us.
Muchas de sus acciones son ejemplares para nosotros.
We can watch how he lived and apply these things to our life.
Podemos ver cómo él vivió y aplicarlas a nuestra vida.
And in this scripture right here, we see that he got away.
Y en estas escrituras podemos ver cómo él se fue yendo.
In fact, in verse 16 it says, but he withdrew to desolate places and pray.
Y en este versículo podemos ver, pero con frecuencia él se retiraba a lugares solitarios y oraba.
Desolate places.
Lugares solitarios.
This is a place where no one else is.
Estos son lugares donde nadie más estaba ahí.
This is a place where Jesus could be alone.
Aquí es el lugar donde él podía estar a solas.
And this was something that he went out of his way to find.
Y él se iba para poder buscar un lugar a solas.
If we were to look at our life,
si nosotros vemos nuestra vida,
what are some desolate places that we have that we can disappear into to pray?
¿A cuáles son los lugares solitarios que nosotros nos podríamos ir a orar?
Tell me, give me an example.
Dime,
what's a desolate place for you?
Dime ejemplos.
The car?
El carro?
The car. And I heard someone say earlier they were like they stopped listening to music and just started praying in the car.
Y alguien me dijo hace rato que se iban al carro, apagaban la música y solamente se sentaban ahí.
They said when they stayed in town it was okay.
Cuando se quedaban en el pueblo estaba bien.
But when they drove to Walmart it was revival.
Pero cuando iban a Walmart era algo diferente.
Just kidding.
Es una broma.
But I think that's an important principle for us.
Pero creo que eso es un principio muy importante para nosotros.
It's important for us to find desolate places.
Es importante para nosotros buscar esos lugares solitarios.
And even if it's just for a short period of time.
Y aunque sea por momentos muy pequeños.
I used to work in a hospital.
Yo antes trabajaba en un hospital.
And every lunch break I found this secret spot.
Y en cada hora de mi comida,
I would cross the street,
yo encontré este lugar, cruzaba la calle,
climb down this little cliff to a river,
bajaba hacia donde había un lago,
It's the city around me.
Era la ciudad alrededor de mí.
But peace within me.
Pero paz adentro de mí.
And I would disappear for my lunch break.
Y yo me desaparecía en la hora de mi tiempo.
25 minutes later, I would come back smiling.
25 minutos después, yo regresaba sonriente.
I was still hungry.
Todavía tenía hambre.
Because what I ate that day was presence with the Lord.
Porque lo que yo comía en ese día era la presencia de Dios.
If you're looking for time, sometimes those meal times are a good time.
Si tú estás buscando tiempo, esos tiempos de tu hora de comer puede ser ese tiempo.
Sometimes that may be pausing to say grace.
Solo, tal vez parar un poquito y dar gracias.
To just thank God for your food.
Solamente da gracias por tus alimentos.
I remember when I first became a Christian, I didn't do that.
Yo recuerdo que cuando recién me convertí en cristiano, yo no oraba por mi comida.
But then I started looking at everything that God brought in my life and I wanted to live in gratefulness.
Y luego empecé a mirar todo lo que Dios traía a mi vida y quise empezar a darle las gracias.
And I still remember the first time this happened.
Y todavía recuerdo la primera vez que esto sucedió.
We were at McDonald's.
Estaba en el McDonald's.
Praying at home is okay.
Orando en la casa está bien.
Praying at McDonald's was a little uncomfortable for me.
Pero orando en el McDonald's me sentía no muy cómodo.
But I remember the moment vividly.
Pero yo recuerdo este momento.
Let us pray.
Vamos a orar.
My wife and I.
Mi esposa y yo.
I thank God for that Big Mac.
Yo le doy gracias a Dios por ese Big Mac.
But more than that, I thanked him for remembering.
Pero más que eso, le doy gracias por el recordar.
Not even remembering to pray.
No solamente por orar.
Remembering God.
Por recordar a Dios.
See, that's the thing that prayer does.
Eso es lo que hace la oración.
When you choose to put prayer in your life, you're placing God there.
Cuando tú tomas la decisión en orar, tú estás poniendo a Dios ahí.
And no matter what situation you're praying about, you're inviting God right into the midst of that.
Y no importa en qué situación estés, pero tú estás invitando a Dios en esa situación.
And that's really important for our lives.
Y eso es muy importante para nuestra vida.
But it's also the reason why you're here.
Y eso es una de las razones por la que usted está aquí.
Not this church on earth.
No es esta iglesia.
God has you here to make a difference.
Dios te tiene aquí para que hagas una diferencia.
He's going to bring people into your life that need to meet you.
Él va a traer gente a tu vida que te tiene que conocer.
And they're going to ask you questions that you don't have the answers for.
Y ellos van a tener preguntas que tal vez tú no sepas la respuesta.
But in that moment, you know where to go to get the answers.
Pero en ese momento tú sabes a dónde ir para agarrar la respuesta.
And so you're turning your attention to God.
Entonces vas a enfocar tu atención a Dios.
That's the beautiful thing about prayer.
Eso es lo hermoso de la oración.
So prayer allows us to say God is important.
La oración nos dice que Dios es importante.
Even if it's just for a moment of silence.
Aunque solamente es un momento de silencio.
Even if it's just a moment to honor God.
Aunque sea un momento para honrar a Dios.
Even if it's just a moment to do something.
Aunque sea el momento para hacer algo.
You're doing that for the glory of God.
Lo estás haciendo para la gloria de Dios.
And so here's what we're going to try to do.
Aquí es lo que nosotros vamos a tratar de hacer.
We are going to try to look at where we are in our prayer life today.
Vamos a ver dónde está nuestra oración en el día de hoy.
And here's what I want you to know about where you are today.
Y aquí es lo que quiero que tú sepas dónde estás tú ahorita.
It's okay.
Está bien.
God ain't gonna leave you there.
Dios no te va a dejar allí.
God's always moving in our life.
Dios siempre se está moviendo en tu vida.
You are where you are today.
Tú estás donde estás ahorita.
But here's the commitment I'm going to ask you to make.
Pero aquí es lo que yo te voy a decir que hagas.
Will you take a small step in the right direction?
Toma un paso chiquito en la dirección que debes de ir.
Take a small step in the direction towards God.
Toma ese paso hacia Dios.
Take a small step towards prayer.
Toma ese paso chiquito a la oración.
And what you might find is God is moving within you in a powerful way.
Y tal vez lo que encontrarás es que Dios está moviendo adentro de ti en una forma poderosa.
No matter where your life is today,
no importa dónde tu vida esté ahorita,
God can work in it.
Dios está trabajando en él.
He wants to work in it.
Él quiere trabajar en él.
He is working in it.
Él está trabajando.
And sometimes prayer allows us to tune in.
Y muchas veces la oración te permite estar espiritualmente allí.
Prayer allows us to ask God.
La oración nos permite hablar con Dios.
Prayer allows us to put him at the center of our lives.
La oración nos permite poner a Dios en el centro de nuestra vida.
We started this service with communion.
Empezamos este servicio con la comunión.
And we talked about the early church, how communion was the centerpiece.
Y hablamos cómo en los tiempos antiguos la comunión era lo centro.
Communion really could easily be prayer.
La comunión fácilmente podría ser la oración.
Because you're having communion with your Father when you pray.
Porque estás teniendo la comunión con tu Padre cuando estás orando.
You're spending time with him.
Estás tomando tiempo con él.
And he's spending time with you.
Y él está tomando tiempo contigo.
So today I just want to encourage you wherever you are.
Ahora solamente quiero decirte que donde estés ahorita,
to move your gaze towards God,
que muevas tu mirada hacia Dios,
and take a small step in that direction.
Y tomes un paso chico en esa dirección.
And I trust that God is going to work in you.
Y yo confío que Dios va a trabajar en ti.
I've seen him work in my life.
Yo lo he visto trabajar en mi vida.
And I've seen him work in the lives of many people that I love.
Y lo estoy viendo trabajando en muchas personas que yo amo.
He wants to work in your life.
Él quiere trabajar en tu vida.
I think it's just time that we invite him in.
Solamente creo que es el momento que lo invites.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's pray.
Vamos a orar.
God, I want to thank you so much.
Dios, te queremos dar las gracias hoy.
For your presence in this place.
Por tu presencia en este lugar.
And the ability that we have to pray.
Y por la habilidad que tenemos de orar.
This week,
en esta semana,
I pray that you encourage us to pray.
Oro que tú nos ayudes a orar.
Call us into communion with you.
Que nos hables a tener comunión contigo.
And show us what the next step is.
Y enséñanos lo que es el siguiente paso.
I pray that in the precious name of Jesus.
Y eso lo decimos en el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
Amen.
In just a minute, we're about to take our tithes and offerings.
En un momento vamos a tomar nuestra ofrenda.
And I'd like to introduce you to a fellow placer by the name of
Tyler Daly.
No, I did that on purpose because I called him Tim earlier by accident. And I thought about it. I was like, should I call him Tim again? No, don't do it, Greg. Don't do it, Greg.
Di una pausa porque hace, yo ya lo conozco y tiene mucho tiempo viniendo aquí, pero lo llamé por el nombre de Tim. Y él no se llama Tim, él se llama Tyler.
Good morning.
Buenos días.
I've been,
Buenas tardes. Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, because we are afternoon now. Sí. Sorry. I was given the opportunity this week to give the offering lesson.
En esta semana me ofrecieron la oportunidad de orar sobre la ofrenda.
And in preparations, I was faced with one of my personal struggles with giving.
Y en mis preparaciones yo estaba batallando porque en veces yo batallo para el dar.
And that's that sometimes I look at the amount I'm giving and it doesn't feel good enough or big enough.
Es que muchas veces veo la cantidad y no se me hace lo suficiente o no es demasiado grande.
But that's not what Christ worries about. He worries about your heart.
Pero eso no es lo que Dios mira, sino él mira tu corazón.
And he can multiply your offering.
Pero él puede multiplicar tu ofrenda.
And when I got to that place, I was reminded of a story.
Cuando llegué a ese lugar, vino a mi mente una historia.
Of when Christ fed 5,000 people with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish.
Cuando Jesucristo tenía 5,000 pedazos de pan y 2 pedazos de pescado.
He went off in a boat, and as he came back ashore, he was greeted with a crowd.
Él se fue a un barco y regresó con un... Un cangrejo. Hey.
He had mercy on them, and he healed their sick.
Tuvo misericordia con ellos y los sanó.
And as the day grew long, the disciples came to him and asked him to send the people away.
Y cuando ellos fueron arrimando, los sanó y dijo, ya pueden irse.
He said, no, we will feed them.
Él dijo, no, yo les voy a dar de comer.
They said to him, but we only have 5 loaves and the 2 fish.
Y él dijo, pero solamente tenemos 2 panes y 2 pescados.
He said, bring them here.
Él dijo, tráelos aquí.
And he looked to the heavens and gave a blessing over them.
Y entonces él miró hacia el cielo y los bendijo.
The disciples then went out to the crowd and they came back with 12 baskets of leftover.
Los discípulos entonces salieron y cuando regresaron, regresaron con 12,000.
So not only did that feed 5,000 people, they had leftovers.
Pero no solamente les pudieron dar a las, todas las personas, pero también les quedó bastante.
So I say to you that if you feel that what you're giving is too small, know that Christ is the miracle worker.
Entonces ahora les quiero decir que si tú crees que lo que tú vas a dar es muy chiquito, no te preocupes porque Dios conoce tu corazón.
And that he will multiply that offering.
Y él va a multiplicar esa cantidad.
And one of the ways that helps us is that, in speaking of feeding, is it helps with our Thanksgiving dinner.
Y muchas, esto puede ayudar también con nuestro servicio que vamos a tener de Día de Acción de Gracias.
It gives us the chance to open our doors to the community and feed the people.
Nos da a nosotros la oportunidad de abrir nuestras puertas y ayudar a servir a la comunidad.
So with that said, I would like to pray over the offering.
Ahora vamos a orar sobre la ofrenda.
Dear Heavenly Father,
Padre nuestro,
we bow our heads before you as we say a prayer and blessing over the offering.
Estamos dándote gracias por esta ofrenda.
We ask that you help it get to the people and places it needs to go.
Te pedimos que ayudes a esta ofrenda para que vaya a los lugares que necesita que ir.
And we want to thank you for the people that came today.
Y te queremos dar las gracias por las personas que están aquí.
For the speakers that spoke.
Por las personas que hablaron.
And the worship team for their preparations.
Y por los de alabanza.
We love you and thank you for your spirit today.
Te amamos y gracias por tu espíritu.
And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ.
Y decimos Amen. Esto en el nombre de Jesús. Amen.
Please stand as we sing this chorus of Cornerstone together in Spanish.
Por favor, apárate cuando estamos cantando esta canción.
En Jesús fuerte soy, solo Él mi roca es, sobre la tempestad Él es rey. En Jesús fuerte soy, solo Él mi roca es, sobre la tempestad Él es rey.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much for being here today.
Muchas gracias por venir hoy.
I'd like to close with a prayer.
Vamos a cerrar con una oración.
I'm going to pray in Spanish. Is that okay?
Vamos a orar en español. ¿Está bien?
Gracias.
Thank you.
Señor, muchas gracias por hoy.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today.
Muchas gracias por su presencia, Señor.
Thank you for your presence.
Eres aquí.
You are here.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Ayúdanos, Señor.
Help us, Jesus.
Te necesitamos.
We need you.
Te necesitamos mucho en este momento.
We need you a lot at this time.
Ayuda esas personas en la iglesia.
Help all these people in this church.
Esta semana vivir para ti.
That this week we can live for you.
Gracias por hoy.
Thank you for today.
Y gracias por su amor.
And thank you for your love.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much for being here. God bless you.
Gracias.